Long ago, in the Himalayan foothills, a miracle's about to happen.
Mahamaya. Mahamaya, wake up. What happened? Why were you giggling?
I had a strange dream, Your Majesty.
I thought as much. Tell me, what was it?
A beautiful dream. A star from the sky and an elephant.
An elephant?
Yes, my lord. With six tusks.
Six tusks?
Yes, with six tusks. This white elephant, it came down to me and into my belly.
Ah, really?
The royal astrologer was summoned to interpret the queen's dream.
Good morning, Your Majesty. I have interpreted the queen's dream. You are going to be a father, Your Majesty.
What's it going to be?
Oh, let me see.
A boy or a girl?
A boy, indeed! The kingdom is going to have a handsome prince, a holy child, who will deliver men from ignorance or rule this world. Yes, rule this world, if he so desires.
What do you mean, if he so desires? My son will rule the world.
Yes, and no deliverance from ignorance, please. May I go to Lumbini for confinement?
Of course. I'll send you when the right time comes.
What's this force that's coming through me? What's this force that's coming?
Isn't it beautiful, Pushpika?
So divine.
Yes, of course, Your Majesty. Oh, I sense a strange feeling.
What is it, Ranima?
I feel him kicking inside me. Pushpika, I think the time has come.
Now, Ranima?
Yes, now. I can feel it. Let's stop here. It feels so nice.
A baby's being born. And the mother says she doesn't feel any pain. I can't believe this.
There is only one explanation. The child must be a blessed one.
Into your wondrous depth. My heart quickens with every step, and so does my breath.
Your Majesty, are you all right? Yes. I didn't expect it to feel so wonderful, Pushpika.
My heart quickens with every step, and so does my breath. I hear the voice of God, Father of men. Say, don't be scared, it's part of the plan. Be trusting this way. Come here, come here. I sense that the hour is drawing near, but I feel
Ranima has given birth! It's a boy!
Oh, he's so cute.
Yes, he's lovely. Look at this!
enlightenment. This is my last life in this world of consciousness.
Look at these chakras. So clear. So beautiful. 12 of them.
What do they mean, astrologer?
Yes, what do they mean?
Your son is going to be a great leader of a different kind, Your Majesty.
What?
Yes.
A different kind of ruler?
Yes, Maharaj. Very different. This child might rule the entire world. Or he may save the entire human race from suffering. But a great leader he will be.
No, no, no. No saving the world from suffering. I want my son to rule my kingdom. And the whole world, if possible. You have given me a very special child, my queen. In due time, I will give him a divine disc, a sturdy horse, a snow-white elephant, an unconquered general, and...
And?
A beautiful young wife, just like you.
All right, all right.
Let him have his beautiful young wife later. Now it's time for him to get some sleep.
Soon the king ordered the wise ministers to gather in the royal hall.
Gentlemen, I would like you to suggest a name for my son. A name that would go down in the history of my kingdom.
Let's call him Sarvati Siddha. Prosperity in everything.
Sarvati Siddha.
Yes.
Sarvati Siddha.
No, it's too long a name. But I like the second half of it. Siddha. Siddha means victory. Siddha. Siddha. Siddharth. Siddharth. What about the name Siddharth?
Siddharth.
Siddharth. Siddharth.
It's a perfect name.
Do you like it?
Of course I like it. Siddharth is a beautiful name. Do you like it, Siddharth?
Yes, Randeva. It's a beautiful name.
Greetings, O Holy One.
Welcome. Welcome, Sejasita. We feel honored by your presence.
Greetings, Maharaj. Oh, little one, you are Siddharth.
But instead of rejoicing, Sejasita burst into tears.
Why are you crying, O Holy One? We have a child. Isn't this an occasion for rejoice?
Maharaj, I do not worship anyone, but to this child I bow down in reverence. This child will preach the law and save the entire human race. Maharaj, the birth of your son is a great event, perhaps the greatest.
But then that should make you happy.
But I'm old. And I'm not going to be alive.
I feel happy for my son.
Not too happy, for a sword will enter your heart due to this child. As for you, my queen, you have become very dear to mankind. You will soon die peacefully. No more pain, no more suffering.
Someone, please take this hermit away before he predicts anything more.
The sorrow of the queen's impending death hung heavy in the air.
My dear sister, I'm handing over my son to you. I know that you'll take good care of him. I feel so happy that I have given birth to such a great child.
Thank you. not live long.
I'm wondering why Ranima hasn't woken up yet. Ranima? Ranima, please wake up, Ranima. Oh. Ranima? Oh, come, my child.
Young Siddharth lived a sheltered and privileged childhood filled with all the comfort that a prince deserved.
Hey, Siddharth, come on, let's play.
Not now, Devadatta. Later.
All right. Thinking as usual. Let's go, Chana.
This is strange. Siddharth doesn't play at all. Either he reads or just sits and thinks. It's very abnormal.
Don't worry, Maharaj. The prince will soon be all right.
Siddharth, what are you doing here all alone?
Nothing. I was just sitting here.
Is something bothering you, my son?
No, father. Why do you ask?
Because you don't play, my son. Boys of your age must play.
I play, father. I do play sometimes.
Sometimes. Only sometimes. What about other times, son?
I think, father.
Thinking, my son, is for elders like us. Boys your age should not think.
Why, father?
You are a prince, my son. And you know what that means, don't you?
Yes, I know. I shall become the king later.
Exactly. You were born to rule. So, I am going to send you to sage Vishwamitra, who will teach you everything that a prince like you ought to know.
Very well, father. I'll go.
I'm going to teach you to write the scriptures. Now, watch me carefully. Om Tatsivitur Varanium.
Shall I try?
Can you?
Yes. Om Tatsivitur.
That's enough, Siddharth. Stop writing. Where did you learn all this?
I didn't learn. I knew.
Now, let me teach you some numerals. Now, repeat after me. One.
One.
Two.
Two.
Three.
Three.
Four.
Four.
Five.
Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. 10. 20. 30. 40. 50. 60. 50 multiplied by 2 equals 100. 100 multiplied by 10 equals 1,000. 1,000 divided by 2 equals 500. 500 minus 200 equals 300. 300 multiplied by 400 equals 120,000. But I can continue, Gurudev.
No, that will do. You seem to know the scriptures and the numbers. Let me teach you some lengths and distances.
Gurudev, let's take the whisker point of a mouse. 10 of these is 1 likya. 10 likyas is a yuka. 10 yukas, a heart of barley. 7 such is the waist of a wasp. From this we can go to the mung. Mustard, barley, corn. 10 such give a finger joint, 12 joints to span from where we reach the cubit. The staff, bow lance, an enhanced length. 20 lengths of lance is what we call a breath, the length one can walk with lungs filled. 44 breaths is a yojana. And Guru Dev, I can tell you the number of yojanas to the sun.
Guru Vishnu.
Huh? Guru Dev, please, please don't do this. You are still my guru. I revere you. Please get up.
Oh, great one. I have nothing to teach you. You are the teacher of all teachers. I worship you. Your knowledge and wisdom are complete.
I'm ready, my cousin.
Here it is. Shoot it down.
It's not yours. It belongs to the sky.
What do you mean it belongs to the sky? I killed it, so it's mine.
No, you have not killed the swan. You've only killed its flight. We must cure its wound.
Cure its wound?
And release it to the sky, too.
Look, my cousin. It is my aim, my bow, my arrow, and my shot. So the bird is my trophy. Now give it to me, will you?
No, Devadatta, I can't do that.
Siddharth, look, you're acting funny.
This bird is mine.
By what right?
By right of mercy. I happen to be an interpreter of the bird's speechless world.
In which case, I'm taking this matter to the elders.
The savior of a life owns the living thing more than the slayer. the slayer destroys and wastes. The cherisher sustains. Therefore, my dear Siddharth, the bird in your hand belongs to you. Take it and care for it.
Siddharth, my son, I am glad you saved the swan.
Thank you, Father. But there's one more thing.
What is it, my son?
You must forgive Devadatta.
Oh, yes, of course. Son.
Father!
Come, Siddharth. Let's take a stroll around the countryside. Is beautiful. Isn't it, my son?
No, Father.
Why do you say that? We saw so many beautiful things.
Yes, Father, I agree. But at the same time, I saw life living upon death. Each slayer slew another and in turn would be slain. I only saw the war between the weak and the strong. I only saw exploitation. I'm confused, Father. I need to think.
A prophecy will soon come true. A prophecy that heaven's true. You shall be a king to guide the people, their spirit and their soul. A prophecy will soon come true, a prophecy that heaven's true. You shall be a king to guide the people, their spirit and their soul. Soon come true, a prophecy that heaven's true.
As Siddharth grew up, his thinking mind persisted.
Look at him. I provide him with every comfort in the world, and yet he is not happy. I fail to understand what his problem is. But come what may, I want him to be the King of Kings, the greatest ruler.
Don't worry, Maharaj. Love is all he needs. The boy does not know the magic of a woman yet.
Maybe you're right. But how do we get the right girl?
Ah, it's not a difficult job, Maharaj. You just leave it to me.
Tell me, what are you going to do?
Ah, we'll order a festival, Maharaj. Only for women. Only for young women. Let all of the virgins of our kingdom compete. I'm sure there will be at least two or three who are interesting. After all, he's 18. And at 18, well, you know.
All right. Don't exert yourself. To see so many beautiful girls all in one place. Isn't it, Mantri?
Absolutely, Maharaj. I had no idea the kingdom was so abundant.
My son is going to have a tough time selecting one from so many exquisite beauties.
Do you think we should go down there and help?
What is this stirring me? What is this burning me? A feeling so delightful, a feeling so strong. I really wonder what's wrong.
She is exquisite. Who is this girl?
She is Yashodhara, daughter of the great king Suprabodha.
Wonderful! Send a message as soon as you can. We will ask Suprabodha for his daughter's hand in marriage to my son.
Yes, Maharaj. But it seems that many princes from far and near are asking for the hand of Princess Yashodhara.
Is that so? Then what does Supra Buddha have to say?
He says that if our prince can win the great warriors' contest, he'd be too glad to give his daughter's hand and the kingdom to our Siddharth.
Siddharth can do that.
Contest!
Oh.
The contestants can choose the distances they prefer.
Place mine at 6 distances away.
Set mine at 8.
Place mine at 10 distances away.
Did you hear that? A clear 2 distances more than Devadatta.
Hey, you know, I've been seeing that bow in the temple ever since I was a little kid. It's gonna take a really strong arm to string it.
Son.
Next is the sword challenge. The contestants will have to cut each tree trunk in a single stroke. Mind you, the second tree trunk is 2 times bigger than the first one. And the third tree is twice as big as the second one. Here we go. The sword contest starts now. Contestant can try his luck.
Thank you.
Did you call me, Majesty?
Yes, my child. I have something important to tell you.
Is there something bothering you, my father?
Listen, Yashodhara. Within these walls, no mention should be made about death, or aging, sorrow, pain, illness, or anything that is not pleasant. I want you to be happy, blissfully happy, all of the time.
But why? Do you suspect that we're going to be unhappy?
No, of course not. It's just the way I brought him up, and it's the way I want him to be hereafter.
But Your Majesty, tell me, why should my husband only look at one side of life?
The prince, my child, has a small problem. He has this tendency to wistfulness and brooding. He gets upset for even small disturbances.
So what would you advise me to do, Your Majesty?
Keep him happy, Yashodhara. Keep him very happy, always. Keep him in the prison of your love, where love is the jailer and delight the bar.
Thank you for your concern. But no prison can stop my thinking, dear father.
Did something scare you?
No, I'm all right.
Was it a bad dream? I've been noticing you for some time now. You seem to be upset about something. You always seem to be preoccupied. Is it me? Has it got anything to do with me?
No, my dear. It's not you. It's me. Something within me.
But whatever it is, please share your thoughts with me.
I love you. I love you so much. Please, believe me. Sometimes I have these dreams. Strange dreams.
Ah, such as?
Really, it's nothing. Don't get upset.
You know, sometimes when I look at you, you look like...
Yashodhara, listen. Do you hear it?
Hear what?
The song. The song of the angels.
No, I don't hear anything.
But I hear it. Music, so divine. Did you hear it? Did you hear it?
No, my lord. I didn't hear a thing.
I definitely heard it. Yes, loud and clear. That was the call. I know it was the call. Chitra? Chitra?
Yes, Prince Siddharth?
Tell me, Chitra, what lies beyond those gates?
It's your city, Prince. Houses, markets, rivers, roads, temples, gardens, fields.
And beyond those?
Beyond those is the jungle. And beyond that is King Bimbisara's kingdom.
Mm-hmm. And beyond that?
The vast world with millions of people, Prince.
Tell me, Chitra, why have I never seen any of these things? Why have I never, ever gone out of those gates?
Your father's orders, Prince.
Is that so? Well, I want to see everything. I want to see what lies beyond those high walls. Let word be sent that I am visiting. And please ask Channa to yoke my chariot by tomorrow noon. I will see what lies beyond those closed gates.
So the time has come. I thought it would be later.
All right, we'll face this. Let him go out and see the world.
Let there be happiness everywhere. Let my son see only good things.
Our prince is visiting the city today.
There should be no evil sight seen anywhere. The blind and the invalids are requested to stay in their homes. I repeat, the blind, the invalids, and the old are requested to stay locked and silent indoors. This is the king's order, and this is to be followed until nightfall.
Siddharth ventured out of the palace for the first time.
There lies your city, Prince. The city you loved even before you saw it. The city is now ready to meet you.
Namaste. Thank you. Namaste. This is wonderful. I like them, and they simply love me. Tell me, Chana, what have I done to make them so happy?
They're happy because you've come to see them.
This is amazing. These people look so bright and cheerful. I am so glad I can bring them so much pleasure.
They sure are happy.
I'd like to see some more.
Jai Ho, noble prince, Jai Ho! Long live the prince! Hey, you!
Stop!
Stop.
Who is that?
That's an old man.
Forget him, Prince. He's just a dying old man.
What do you mean, dying?
Dying, death is something natural.
But does one look like this, so miserable, when one is dying?
Anybody who becomes old just looks like that.
Will I also look like that man when I grow old? When I die? Will I die? Answer me. Will I grow old, look like this old man, and die?
Yes. Yes.
Will your shoulder die too?
What kind of life is this, which you see as eternal bliss? Oh, were you just a blind man, bitten by life's deceptive kiss? Everything is just an illusion. Oh, Prince, how fatal can be your delusion?
Are you happy with me? Do I not provide you with all of the comforts that you deserve?
Sweetheart, happiness, comfort, These are all illusions. We cannot hold on to these things because one day all of these things will just disappear. Time will take everything from us, my dear. My passion, your beauty, our youth. It will take away everything. All, everything. I saw all of this today, and what I saw is still disturbing me.
But then, it has always been like this, my lord. We cannot change this.
I know that, but it's still disturbing me, and I don't think I shall be able to sleep anymore.
King Shadodana had a strange dream that seemed to indicate the role of his son in the future.
Open the door. I wish to go out right now.
I'm extremely sorry, Prince, but I cannot do that.
Why?
They're your father's orders, Prince. I have been ordered not to let you out of the palace at any time.
Oh, I see. Well, can I meet with him, or has that also been forbidden by my father? Father! Please, answer me. Why am I not being allowed to go out into the city?
It's for your own good, my son. You are extremely sensitive, and you think too much. Besides, you have already seen the city, haven't you?
Oh, yes. I saw it. And everything seemed to have been prearranged by you, and nothing was normal. The whole thing was a setup, Father. And everybody was happy and laughing.
What's wrong with laughing? What is wrong in being happy?
Nothing, if it were natural. Don't try and stage a happy world for me, Father. If you want me to rule this land, you must let me know it as it is. I want to know the people. Their feelings, their day-to-day lives, their dreams, their problems. Fears, their sorrows, and their hopes.
Well, I suppose you are right. Maybe I was being overcautious. Maybe I was overprotective. All right, son, from now on, you are free to go anywhere you want, to do whatever you desire.
Chana. How do I look? Do you think that people will be able to recognize me as I walk through the streets?
Absolutely not.
Very good then. Let's go.
Help me. Somebody help me. Somebody help me. I can't bear this anymore. I can't bear this pain. Help me, please. Help me. Help me,
no.
Please.
No, no, my lord. He is ill, sick with some disease. Please, please don't touch him.
Brother, why are you crying? What's wrong with you? Chana, why is he crying?
Don't touch him, my lord. You might get the plague.
I might get the plague? What is this, Chana? Are there others? Many others like this man?
Sick men? Yes, that's an eternal truth. It's part of life. Almost every man, every woman, every child at some point in time falls ill from fevers, upset stomachs, rashes, all sorts of illnesses. Nobody's free from them.
This illness, does it come unobserved, or is there some way of knowing about it earlier?
No, not until one gets it. It comes silently, like a snake, until all of a sudden it strikes out, like a flash of lightning.
Chana, what happens when people fall ill?
You're seeing it. They suffer, waste away, weaken, and die.
Die?
Yes, die, decay, disappear from the face of the earth.
Die. Tell me, Chana, will I fall ill? Will I die?
I feel sad to say this, Prince, but yes, you too will fall ill. You too will die. Huh? You, me, and everyone. No one can escape.
Is that why all men live in fear?
Yes, all men, my lord.
So nobody who is alive today can say, I am sure that I will be alive tomorrow.
No one can say that. We will all have to die, my lord.
I see.
Yes, my lord. The fortunate ones live longer without any serious illness, but they too grow old and one day stop living. The others die earlier. Illness, suffering.
What, Chana? Why is he not moving?
He's dead. His agony is over.
What?
He's gone.
Suffering world caught in the common net of life and death. I thought life was everlasting, never ending.
Unfortunately, it is not.
Men need to be awakened from their illusion in this world where death is the only sure thing. They need help, Chana. They, me, you, us, we all need help. Why only us? The gods may also need help, perhaps.
You said gods, my lord. They created the world, didn't they?
Chana, I don't think Brahma would create this world and be silent about its miseries. If he is all-powerful, he should prevent these miseries and these sufferings and these deaths, but he's not doing this.
Prince! Prince!
Prince, I have good news. You have been blessed with a son.
Oh, what happy news! That's beautiful! A little Siddharth to play with.
There is nothing beautiful about this, Chana. This is just another bond to tie me tight. So name him Rahula. Rahula means snake, or a rope that has come to pull me back.
What kind of life is this, which you see as eternal bliss? Oh, were you just a blind man, bitten by life's deceptive kiss? Everything is just an illusion. Oh, Prince,
Chana. Master.
Bring out Kentucka.
My lord. My lord, you want to ride now? In the middle of the night? But why?
Shh. Speak low. I have to go. The hour has come, Chana.
For what, my lord?
To find the truth, which I will seek for everyone's sake.
But where are you going?
I do not know.
But, my lord, think of your father, your son, the princess.
I have to give up all of my comforts for a greater cause, Chana. For the happiness of all mankind. A joy forever. So don't waste any more time, Chana. Go bring me my horse. Kentucka, this may be your longest journey, because I do not know where this quest will finally end. Chana, take care of Rahula and my dear Yashodhara.
Prince Siddharth, please accept the regards of Mara, the Lord of Temptation. It's wonderful to see you. But my dear sir, may I please ask where you are going at this hour?
I am going to seek the truth.
Seven days from now, Prince Siddharth will be the unchallenged ruler of the great empire. 7 days from now, men and women will wait with utmost desire for your slightest indication for them to surrender and quench their thirst at serving thy great king.
Mara, temptation cannot win me over anymore. No longer do I wear the cloak of desire.
Huh?
Everything is just an illusion. Oh, Prince, how fatal can be a delusion? Depart, ride swift into the night. Do not falter and do not sway until you find your chosen way. Everything is just an illusion. Oh, Prince, how fatal can be your delusion?
Goodbye, Kentucka. I know it will be hard, but I have to give up everything to save this world and all mankind. Goodbye, my friend.
and you left everything? But what for?
To seek the true meaning of life.
But young man, do you have any idea how difficult...
I know very well.
But for that, you must have faith.
My conduct is good. I do meditate and I have faith.
Then you will find what you are looking for.
The ascetics, drawn by Siddharth's words, decided to follow him.
Siddharth meditated without food or water, exposing himself to the elements until he was at the brink of death.
Starve like this. Have this. They say there is a healthy mind only in a healthy body.
What is your name?
Sujata.
You have given me new life. Your wisdom has made me understand that complete renunciation is not the path. I will therefore meditate with a healthy mind and a healthy body. I will follow the middle path between self-mortification and self-indulgence. Come, share with me.
Siddharth, you have given up.
You've broken your resolution.
We can't follow you anymore.
Fire cannot be made of damp wood, my friends. I have found the middle path. And, my friends, this is the path. May you find peace for your kindness.
Thank you, O Holy One.
Thank you.
Nirvana and leave the world.
No, not yet. It is not yet time, Mara.
And why not? You will have all your answers, won't you?
I have to spread this knowledge. Everything I know must be given to save all mankind.
No. You cannot do that. You cannot do that! I will not let you do that! No!
Path that will lead to the end of all suffering. At last, I am free from all desire and ignorance.
But how can you know the truth? You gave up, didn't you?
No, I never gave up. Neither the life of worldly pleasure, nor the life of mortification and self-denial can bring about enlightenment. The path to Nirvana is eightfold. Try and understand this. Right faith, right resolve, right speech, right action, right living, right effort, right thought, and right concentration. And this is the middle path.
Forgive us. Forgive our ignorance.
O great one,
accept us as your disciples.
O disciples, now it is time to travel far and wide. Time to go in all directions. Time to preach and spread the Eightfold Law. Come, let us go.
Buddha sought to teach and reform. And he touched many that he encountered in his travels.
Oh, you poor little baby.
Stop! Please, give it back.
Where are you taking them, my friend? Please tell me.
There, to the sacrificial hall. We've been asked by the priest to sacrifice 100 sheep.
What for?
To worship the gods.
We shall go there. Come.
Yeah.
Let him not strike, O great king.
Who is this person?
He is the Buddha.
What should we do? Tell us, O holy one, have we done something wrong?
All creatures, even the meanest of them, love life, O king. Life is dear, very dear, even to this crippled lamb, and it is your duty to protect them all.
Oh.
Shh!
You are as much a king to this little lamb as you are to your people.
Damn.
This little lamb trusts you as much as your people do, and at your whim, the sword will fall, and you will take away the life of this little crippled lamb, just like that. But, O king, you cannot expect a sin like killing to fetch you blessings of forgiveness from other sins.
What should I do?
Proclaim the banning of all slaughter in your kingdom.
For your life?
No, I am not. It is you who seems to be running away.
What?
I am at peace. It is you who is in restless motion.
What are you talking about?
My mind is at rest. You have yet to find peace, my child.
My child? You can't mean that. Do you know who I am?
Yes, Angulimala.
What do you know? I am the dreaded monster, feeding on human flesh.
No, my friend. You are a lost soul, crying for help.
Help? What do you people know about helping? Except blatant cruelty.
No, my child. All are not evil. Maybe ignorant. But the world is not entirely a bad place.
Why should I try to understand? When nobody tries to understand me.
I am sorry for what has happened to you, but you cannot gain anything by further torturing yourself.
No, I'm not. I'm torturing others.
By denying your conscience, what is it that you hope to gain?
Enough. I don't want your words. I want your little fingers.
Take them, my child, if it makes you happy.
And along with your fingers, I will take your life too.
By all means do, my child, if it brings you any peace of mind.
Ugh.
During his travels, Buddha preached his message and soon headed towards his homeland. The eternal beauty of nature, which amazed him, seemed just as beautiful as always. The lofty peaks, the melting snow, the flowing streams, and the withering leaves all have a message for those who seek.
The streets I was once forbidden to tread, the people I was not allowed to mingle with, and the side of life I was not supposed to know. I grew up here, ran those corridors, and played in those gardens. I enjoyed the pleasures of life and thought it was forever. There, I fell in love, married, and fathered a child. Oh, Yashodhara, Rahula, where am I? What am I doing here? How strong are the chains that bind us to this endless cycle of illusion?
The prince has returned. Oh, really? My prince?
Father, I am blessed to see you again.
Siddharth, where have you been? Why did you leave us? And what has happened to you, my son?
The miseries of life you tried so hard to hide from me, the realities of human frailty you made me believe did not exist, made me go places in search of truth and an answer for my troubled mind.
So, did you find them?
Yes, indeed. And I have come to share them with all of you.
Indeed, my son. I always knew in the back of my mind that you would find your destiny. God bless you.
My lord, don't leave me again. Please stay with us.
Princess.
Yes, it's me. And this is Rahul, our son.
Fair one, I found love in your arms, but my restless spirit was tied to this place of gold. I have to go to do what I must do.
Take me with you, my lord. I want to be with you always.
Forgive me for the pain I've caused, but I am no longer the man who was your husband and father of your child.
Thus, Prince Siddharth, having abandoned worldly comforts, the kingdom, a loving family, and wealth, sought out the truth of all. After much suffering and meditation, Prince Siddharth became Bodhisattva, the seeker of truth, and then Buddha, the enlightened. His preaching about compassion, shunning all evil and doing good deeds, was followed by many, and thus was founded a great religion called Buddhism. Buddhism has spread to many countries around the world, including Sri Lanka, Tibet, Myanmar, Thailand, China, Japan, Vietnam, and Singapore. Today, it even has many followers in the West.
Buddham saram gacchami. Dhammam saram gacchami. Sangham saram gacchami.